Welcome to Lunar Elements. My name is Amanda and this is for the Virgo Moon Transit between the 20th and the 22nd of May. And this is for Earth signs, so Taurus, Virgo and Capricorn. So I'm going to change things up a little bit differently. I'm not going to go so much into the astrology. If it comes up, it comes up. However, I want to try and make these a little bit shorter so that faster upload time and recording time, and then that will assist me on being more consistent for my schedule. So the first card that was cut for this transit was the Five of Swords. Now, being in Moon in Virgo, it's not surprising because Virgo is the analyzer of the zodiac, but let's get into it. So first sign off the rank is Taurus, and Taurus, this is hitting off in your fifth house of Leo, therefore being ruled by the sun. So what do we have for Taurus, please? They're just saying this moon transit after the moon being in Leo and the heart activations that the collective were receiving, which I have been receiving as well today, which is the 18th of May, on the day I'm recording these. Today I've been processing a lot of heart activation energy, and I have been in completely different energy. Sorry, I just have to... Okay, sorry about that. I had to put my phone on airplane mode. I have been in completely different energy. I've been listening to a beautiful Solfeggio frequency tune that a girlfriend sent me, which I'll link in the description box for you guys. And I have just been receiving heart activations for probably the last 4 or 5 hours. And for many of you who don't know, for sometimes that can be a burning sensation in the back between your shoulder blades. That's what I've been receiving, and I've been receiving beautiful divine downloads, and I feel that my heart has just been expanding more and more and more. And so I've just been in this energy of feeling what was coming through when I was preparing for these recordings was the divine Mother Mary Magdalene energy that was coming through, you know, almost... like, or not almost, it is that high of unconditional love, that high vibrational unconditional love. And I feel it's like Palladian energy, which is came in via divine message for me just the other day. So Taurus, what cards do we have for Taurus, please? Okay, the first card out for you is the Two of Swords. So again, if you're receiving, or if you're not open to opening your heart up fully, I feel that this Virgonian, and we just have three to flip out, so it's the Three of Cups here, and then the Empress energy come out as well. So if you are having, I'm just getting chills thinking about it, that Taurus, if you are having problems with tapping in and opening your heart now, for whatever reason, I want to say, and with the Queen of Pentacles on the underlying energies here, I want to say that, can you repeat that please? You need to play more. You need to activate this energy of the Empress within you as well, like connecting with your divine feminine energies within, you know, for the masculine and the feminines, masculines and feminines, because this is also can be your card as well, Taurus, because there is the Venus glyph there right next to her cushion. So this beautiful divine mother energy that I'm feeling, for this Virgonian, because she is the maiden, she is the healer of the zodiac. And I feel that whilst preparing for that, these recordings, that's why Mary Magdalene came in so strongly for this reading, and why I feel like I'm in complete divine, I feel like I'm in a divine embrace right now. I feel so calm and so in my heart, and I feel Taurus, with this action coming through in your fifth house of Leo, this is that child energy too. You know, think of the sun card. That is the boy is on the back of the horse, reminiscent of Merlin, and he's having fun, you know, he's playing jokes. So Taurus, whatever is keeping you locking down your heart is the phrase they're giving me right now. Know that there is going to be healing available for you throughout this Virgo moon transit. And just trust that. Just trust it, because yes, it... Okay, so this is speaking from experience, but what's coming through right now is my guides are showing me and reminding me of the beginning of my journey, of my spiritual awakening. Excuse me. And I received a heart activation to the point where I felt like I was having a heart attack, and there was that tremendous amount of pressure activating through the front, through my heart, and I broke down in tears, because when we have lived with our hearts caged or closed off for so long in our lives, as I had done, when you open that back up again, there are going to be tears. It is going to be scary. The way in which you channel that energy is by activating your inner child again and making yourself drop into that childhood fun aspect of yourself. Of they're giving me that phrase, like, be who you were before they fucked you up, you know? And it is that energy. It's, you need to trust again, Taurus. You have a beautiful big heart, and you need to trust again to reopen that, okay? Because with the three of cups and the Empress here, thank you, they just said some of you aren't going to have a choice in the matter, so why fight it? And your clarifier is the Hermit card, which is the card for Virgo, you know? So do the self-healing work. No more spiritual bypassing, you know, do that work that you know is going to heal this area for you. And yes, it will be scary, and yes, it may be painful. However, you know that on the other side of that is this Three of Cups and this Empress energy of divine love. So I'm going to leave it there for you, Taurus. Just before I go, the underlying message is justice as well. So perhaps this is a very karmic time for you right now, and they are reminding me that Jupiter has returned to Pisces since January of 2010. 18th of January 2010 was when Jupiter re-entered Pisces, so perhaps there is a resurgence, or perhaps there are memories from 2010 which may be playing out for you right now. So Taurus, I'm going to leave it there. Thank you so much for being here. Please like, share and subscribe. Check out the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one, and stay tuned to this channel, because I have a beautiful announcement in the coming days, okay? Bye. Next up is Virgo. Virgo, this is of course hitting off in your first house, which is ruled by Mars and thus Aries. What messages do we have for Virgo, please? Thank you. Remember, you are the divine healer, they are saying. Remember, you are the Florence Nightingale to the collective. You always have been. You know how to heal. Whether it doesn't matter, they're saying it doesn't matter what your frequency of consciousness is. They are saying you know how to heal yourself. You know how to heal others. Your compassion is unmatched. And you need to start facing that inward. What messages do you have for this Virgo? Pardon me. The Tower card. So Virgo, where is it? And stay around, because this doesn't have to be disaster, chaotic energies. However, if you are having, they're just telling me, a spiritual awakening right now, because you notice how the top of the tower here has a crown on it. The top of the tower that's being blown off, it looks like a crown. So perhaps Virgo, throughout this transit, you might find, especially because you're opposing Pisces and Neptune's returned there after it's, you know, it has returned there from 2011. It retrograded and returned in 2012 to Pisces. So perhaps there is a reflection there for you too. However, with this coming in as, like, normally the judgment is spiritual awakening, but with this tower giving me a spiritual awakening vibe, focusing me on the crown, I feel that the divine activations and downloads that are going to be coming in for you when the moon opposes Neptune, you can't ignore those, because they're going to be from yourself, your higher self, and the divine. And they're just telling me to really balance out your energies and ground your energies whilst you're walking that shaman line of, am I going fucking crazy? Or is what I am seeing actually the truth, you know? Because with an opposition, the best way to traverse that is to find the polarity between harmonizing whatever planets are in opposition, you know. So you're going to see the moon, which is your subconscious and your emotions and the way in which you love and you process emotions. You were going, and also our intuition, of course, because it's the feminine, divine feminine, intuitive aspect, right? We're going to see that opposing Neptune. I feel for you, Virgo, that during this opposition, it would be very wise for you to check at what degree your sun, moon, or rising is, or your progressed sun, moon, or rising is in Virgo, and then track the moon to when it comes over that degree, and then track the moon again to know when that your natal or progressed sun, moon, or rising conjuncts the moon. And if that aligns with the 22 degree, it's almost 23 degrees. I believe it's the numbers they're showing me right now are 22 degrees and 53 minutes, or 54 minutes, sorry, 53, 54 minutes, you know. So pay attention to the degree in which your natal and progressed degrees are in Virgo. Track the moon to when you were going to receive the moon conjuncting that degree, and then pay special attention to what day this will hit off for you when it opposes Neptune, okay? Pardon me, yes, the World card. So again, this aligns to me with the spiritual awakening and the activation of the crown, because you've completed a journey here, a chapter, you know. This, the World card, is the end of the major arcana, and underneath that you've got the Magician card. So you have been activated most definitely in this last, yep, and you've got the Eight of Cups. So this is going away to consolidate our emotions, right? He's walking away to the moon, you know? So pay attention to the moon. especially as I said, because I feel as well this is giving me like the ring around the woman is giving me Saturnian vibes. You know, Saturn's the only planet with rings. It's giving me those sorts of vibes, and like Saturn rules karma. Saturn is Kronos, the lord of time, okay? And so I feel that you might want to, what's coming through now is as well, you might want to look to what personal year you are traversing in numerology. I feel many of you watching this will be in a 7 year, and that's more often than not when most of us will experience a spiritual awakening or reawakening. And I feel that if you don't know how to do that as well, thank you, one moment. If you don't know how to do the numerology, you add the date and the month as a number together, and then you add that to 2021. So we're in a five universal year right now. So this is all about change, death, and rebirth, you know. This is why we are seeing, not just with the astrology alone, but numerologically, this is why we are seeing the destruction of such government institutions and a complete breakdown of societal norms, you know. And this is why we are the leaders, and we are the light workers. We are the leaders who are here to create this new earth. And that's why I feel it's Virgo, you're coming online is what I'm hearing right now. I'm just getting chills as I'm saying that. So please make time to meditate as well. They're telling me right now with this Eight of Cups as well, because it is a card of contemplation and of walking away. And considering we know that you're closing out a cycle here, I feel that it's time to really embrace the path of the heart, your soul path. You know, Virgo, like you bring, thank you. And we just had the Queen of Swords come out, which is a card for you, Virgo, because this is an air sign, but it's Mercury energy as well. You know, Mercury is the messenger of the gods. So I feel it is time for many of you to take your royal seat, is the message that's coming through right now. And the underlying message here is the Three of Swords and the Six of Cups. So you can't make this up. Like this is definitely energies of massive healing, and of, I feel with the Three of Swords and the Six of Cups together, I feel, as I was saying earlier, it's time to choose the path of the heart. I'm not seeing this as heartbreak as what is normally depicted with the Three of Swords. It may be difficult to walk away from some things, as we do when we shift paradigms and raise our consciousness. However, I really am feeling that this is a soul level heart activation. So the Three Swords are, can you clarify that please? Yeah, they're focusing me on the rain, which is behind in the clouds. Okay, and water is feminine, divine feminine energy, okay? However, with all the many different types of water, we have lakes, we have rivers, we have streams, we have oceans and seas, you know, we have stagnant ponds, and we have rain. And rain is actually a masculine energy. So perhaps it's time for you to really balance that out as well. Not just balance, embrace it, because what I am feeling from these cards is that the power of your feminine is only equally as matched to the power of your divine masculine within, and vice versa, no matter with whom, which energy or whom you resonate with, divine masculine, divine feminine. And I feel right now there is a real big call for your inner divine masculine to hold your feminine because we had the Queen come out. Okay, hold your feminine through this, you know. So I'm gonna leave it there, Virgo. I hope that resonates. Please like, share, and subscribe, and also check out the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one. And stay tuned to this channel because I have a beautiful divine announcement in the coming days, okay? So next up is Capricorn. Capricorn, what do we have for Capricorn? Okay. They're saying that ever since Saturn's ingress into Aquarius, so that was the 17th of December 2020 was its ingress into Aquarius, because it returned to Saturn on the 17th, on the 20th of December 2017. And so ever since your ruling planet has moved into Aquarius, they're telling me, Capricorn, you've been trying to keep up with all of the things that you're holding yourself to. They're telling me you're placing yourself under such ridiculous expectations and setting precedents for yourself, which they're just saying they're unmatched. Sustainable, but unmatched. They're just saying you have to ensure that your self-care is matched. The grander your visions, the more your self-care needs to be amplified, is the message they're giving me right now. So Capricorn, this is hitting off in your ninth house, okay, of Sagittarius and Jupiter. And we have the Eight of Swords come out straight away. So again, you're keeping yourself bound and trapped by limiting beliefs, all right? This is that energy of, thank you. They're just showing me the elephant tied to the stake and with the chain, and the High Priestess has come out as well. So Capricorn, with your planet moving into Aquarius ruled by Uranus, yes, it's at its full in Taurus right now. However, Uranus is the visionary of the Zodiac. And I mean that in a 3D capacity and then multidimensional capacity, because the High Priestess is our intuition. It is ruled by Neptune. It's Piscean energy. And so with this moon transiting your ninth and Jupiter having entered into Pisces again since 2010, there's going to be a resurgence of a requirement for you to really embrace that intuitive knowing and to come out of your head, they're saying, so that you can receive the messages. So you have the Eight of Swords, the High Priestess, and the Ten of Wands, which is just speaks to that switch in focus I was just speaking of, you know. So maybe a clarifier for this spread too. Thank you so much. So the clarifier is the Six of Wands. So there's nothing but success in the future for you, Capricorn. However, you just really need to balance out, and moderate is the word you're giving to me right now. Moderate your expectations, moderate your precedences, you know. Like, I had this exact scenario going on when I first started my blog, and I was one-upping myself every single time, you know, till I reached a point in 2019 where I had worked myself into the ground with the amount of research, study, creating and channeling the blogs, keeping up with all the social media, building my own business. And then when I started doing the blogs, I also started adding video and pulling cards as an extra to that. And it got to the point where I was just creating this scenario for myself, when my heart's hurting just saying this right now. I was creating this scenario for myself where I couldn't even keep up with the next level stuff that I was creating by myself. So with the Devil card here as well, this is very much confirmation of that energy of you're trapped by your own illusion. It's the card, it is your card as well, Capricorn. So when we look to the Devil card, okay, we can see that the two people are representative of Adam and Eve that we earlier saw in the twins, in the Lovers card for Gemini, right? In the Major Arcana. And now we've arrived at the Devil card. This is the spiritual lesson of learning discernment, of learning how to, thank you. What they're saying, Capricorn, is to learn how to dance with the darkness just as you do with the light. You know, like you can't be all love and light without acknowledging the darkness within or external, you know, because one can't exist without the other. It's just balance. The universe requires balance, unfortunately, you know. And yes, the light will win. They're just telling me the light's going to win right now. So that's so beautiful. Thank you. The light will always win is what they're saying. And that came through in a divine download I just posted to social media before recording this. So, however, at the same time, in order to be the bridge, you need to accept, acknowledge, and transmute the underworld and the darkness. As my heart chakra is burning again in between my shoulder blades as I'm saying this. So as much light and love as what you can encompass, that is the depth and the vastness of the darkness that you can overcome in any challenge. So learn to dance with your devils just as well as you do with the angels, and you'll find a lot more harmonious and successful balance here, and you will be able to come out of your head and trust your intuition far more. Because what they're telling me, Capricorn, is that for some of you, there's three or four of you watching this right now, where you are finding yourself just so affixed to the 3D reality and dimension. You're so, whether or not you're just starting to awaken, and that's why you're here on this video, welcome. We've been waiting for you. They're just saying many of you are so focused, so focused on the 3D world because you think you can control it. You can't control it. The divine and the stars and the planets control it. You need to open yourself up to realizing that you are part of something much far greater than you've ever been conditioned, programmed, or indoctrinated to believe. And that's why you're here on this planet. You're a powerhouse, Capricorn. Don't forget it. And success does await you, undoubtedly, undoubtedly. This is also the card for marriage too. So be wary of, thank you. They're just saying be wary of what thoughts you usurp. So Capricorn, I'm going to leave it there. Thank you so much for being here. Please like, share, and subscribe, and stay tuned to this channel because I have a beautiful announcement in the coming days. And check the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll catch you on the next video. Bye.